Hey, bell testers. This is Dr. Krister Shalm here in front of the National Institute of Standards and Technologies, and I'm about to tell you about how you are going to help us perform our big bell test. Now, I'm going to snap my fingers and quantum teleport myself into my lab. Poof! And here we are in my lab. Now, I'm wearing some very special safety goggles that will protect me from the high-powered lasers on the table behind me. And I use those lasers to generate special particles of light. They're entangled, and they allow us to test properties of quantum mechanics. And that's what we're going to be doing in the Big Bell test. Now, what I do in this lab right here is I create these particles of light, and then I send them to distant locations inside of our building, two different labs, where we're going to make measurements on them. And this is where you come in. So let's hop over to one of the labs where we'll actually be doing these measurements. Poof! Here we are outside of one of the labs where we're going to be measuring the little particles of light. So the particles of light have traveled through quite a distance through the ceiling in tiny fiber optic cables made of glass. And then they arrive here and we're going to do some measurements on them. Before we go in the lab, I apologize for the noise. You're going to hear a noise in the background that's kind of a chunk, 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 chunk. That is the sound of one of our fridges. We detect our little particles of light with what you can think of as the world's best cameras, but we have to keep them very, very, very cold, just a fraction of a degree above absolute zero, and the fridges make a horrendous noise. You wouldn't want this in your house. So let's come on in to the actual lab. And what we're going to be doing is measuring a property of the light called polarization. If you've ever been to the movies, like I've seen a 3D movie, when you wear those special glasses, you actually have polarizers in each lens that allow you to see the different types of images that create the 3D image in the illusion of that. Or if you have polarizing sunglasses, we're going to use the same type of thing here. It's just going to be a little bit more fancy. So this is our very fancy polarizing piece of sunglasses. There's a lot of optics here on this table that we're actually going to use to do the measurement. This is the device right here where we can choose how we measure the polarization of the light. We switch it on and off very fast. It only takes about a billionth of a second to turn on and off. And what we're going to do is have you control how this thing operates, the state of how it's going to change the polarization of the light passing through it. And that's what your ones and zeros that you're producing are going to do. They're going to come in and actually influence this device right here. Now, what we're hoping is that with humans, we can see if humans really can influence quantum mechanics and if there's a difference between when you guys control the polarization of the light, or when we just have a computer or some other random number generator do the control. In other words, can humans actually influence quantum mechanics? And if they can, I think that would be really spooky.